taking just a quick break to get this video out before I get to what I'm doing during this quarantine. So, on Facebook, people have been sending around different questions like, hey, what's your favorite color? Post this and tag five others, or like the 10 push-ups, tag 10 type thing. So, on Facebook, I've been working on asking meaningful questions, questions to get me to know my fan base, or my friends, or whatever that is. So today, about 6 hours ago, I asked Alright FB, who's ready for the COVID-19 immunizations? Because with such an outbreak like this, we're not going to sit around and just let this virus come up. So I know there's many people who are into vaccinations, they believe and are behind it fully, and then there's other people who have maybe had conversations or situations that they don't like the virus so much. So I asked RIFB who's ready for the COVID-19 immunizations, and one person, I won't say any names here, says, I'm waiting and hoping it comes soon enough. And then I asked him, why is that? And he said, main reason we are in a quarantine because we don't have immunity against the virus. We are literally dying because of it. Alright, and then this other person says, never, nope, no way, nada, not for me, thank you. I said, why not? And this person said, I believe in the natural remedies that God provides, and have been blessed to see the results of using these remedies many times. Another person says, amen, we have to trust in the Most High. This person says, God provides us with the brains that have allowed us to study how the natural processes that cause diseases work and how to prevent them from starting or cure them after they have started. If you die of vaccine-preventable disease, and when you get to heaven, ask God why he let you die, he will tell you that he gave us scientists who made vaccines so you don't have to choose to die. Another person said, if you trust in man and his vaccines, I can only pray for you. Years ago, maybe vaccines helped us. Now it's a whole different story and world. This person says, why would vaccines have helped years ago and not now? Do you think God allowed us to discover penicillin or the polio or smallpox vaccines? So some of these people are trolling a little bit, but this person says vaccines still save countless lives. Smallpox is the only vaccine-preventable disease that has been wiped out from the planet. We can already see the measles, a disease that was almost gone in the U.S., is coming back due to people refusing to vaccinate their kids. I don't know you personally, but looking at what's publicly available on your Facebook page, I'm guessing you were born around 1960, so this guy's doing research. Less than a decade before you were born, polio leaked in the U.S. with 21,000 people being paralyzed from it in 1952. Shortly after that, cases rapidly declined due to vaccines, and by 1960, there were 2,500 cases that involved paralysis, and it further dropped to 61 in 1965. And after an outbreak in 1979, among Amish who hadn't gotten vaccines, the virus was gone from the U.S., other than a few imported cases over the next two decades. Since you were born after vaccines had already done the work to make the disease less deadly, go talk to someone from your parents' generation about what life was like when polio and other vaccine-preventable diseases were common. Alternatively, find a cemetery from prior 1950 to walk through and look at the gravestones for young children. Then find another one that is newer and see how many more kids live with vaccines. So this person really came with that history right there. This person says, no way. And on that comment, someone said, trust the CDC, FDA, and Gov. Someone said, not at all. Someone said, they trust the government. They said they trust them at -0%. I don't know if that's a number, but. And another person says, it's opinions like that that make it so. Alright, it's opinions like that that make it so dead diseases come back and our immunocompromised citizens will die unnecessarily. Get vaccinated unless physically unable to. There is no risk if you do not have a medical complication. I cannot wait until they find a cure for this, and those I love will be safe. Someone said, I can't come soon enough. Someone said, yes. Weird comment to make. Someone had a GIF with a jumping deer, and it says, nope. It's like a little meme. Alright, someone said, get me some of that good old Lysol right to the veins. We'll be cured. Someone said, the sooner the better. Another person said, highly unlikely. At the soonest, we are looking at a year, at least never. someone put a meme here, and it says, things I trust more than a vaccine from Bill Gates. One of them is a picture of Charlie Sheen, and it said, one night stand with Charlie Sheen. Another one has a pitcher, a gallon water jug of Flint, Michigan water. And the next one says, has like a picture of a Nigerian prince, and it has a Nigerian prince there. Another one has a picture of Casey Anthony, and it says a daycare run by Casey Anthony. Another one has a picture of someone holding like gas station sushi. And then the last picture is Mr. Bill Cosby doing his famous like pudding pop face, and it says cocktails with Bill Cosby. So they're saying they trust these things more than they trust the vaccination. Another person says never to the vaccination. Another person says H-E double hockey stick, no. Another person says, nah, I'm good, chief, gonna stay with my healthy lifestyle and distancing. So that got, you know, more interaction than what usually happens on the post. So thank you everyone for your comments and do your research. Thanks for watching, commenting, liking, and subscribing. Everybody wants to go ahead.